I'm going to move on. I'm so in the hell on. But oh my god, I poked myself in the eye. Don't cry, don't cry, don't cry. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Anusha Nati and I thought it would be fun to do like a base tutorial. I just had a photo shoot and my base stayed on for like more than 10 hours. So I was like, you know, why don't I share you my tips and tricks? Maybe you guys have a photo shoot or like an event you want to go and you want to have like a really good base. It will last long, like really long. And it's a really natural look, but you can like make it your own. It's just about the base. And you know what? If you want to see more, I'm going to start off with my eyebrows for this tutorial. And I'm going to use my Freedom Eyebrow Pomade in the color Dark Brown. It is comparable to the Anastasia Beverly Hills ones. But I have to say, this one like dries really fast in the jar. Like in here. And the Anastasia one is just a tiny bit warmer than the Freedom one. To set it in place, I'm going to use my Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Gel. So I'm now going to move on to my face, and the first primer I'm going to use is my W7 Pore Perfection. I have pores around my nose. Oh, so annoying. And they're pretty big, like no. And I'm going to follow it up with my Smashbox Photo Finish. And just apply it all over the face. I don't know what it is today, but I cannot talk. Okay. So now moving on to foundation. I'm going to mix my LA Girl Pro Coverage with the Milani Conceal and Perfect to get the right shades. And I'm going to mix my foundation with some glow. And for this I'm going to use my Marc Jacobs and my Iconic London. I use this method from Daisy. And I'm just going to mix it with my foundation so you don't have to apply it really neat or something. Okay, so normally I would use my sponge, but my sponge just died today. So now moving on to brushes, because I have like literally no sponge in the house. Like, that's bad. So I'm going to use my e.l.f. brush for this. For concealer, I'm going to use my NARS Soft Matte Complete Concealer in the color Caramel. What I like to do with this one is also just like really do a contour on my nose, on my lids, and then I'm going to mix this with my Revolution Conceal and Define in the color C13. I'm just going to take the same brush and just buffing everything in. So now we have blended this out. I'm going to set it with my Laura Mercier Translucent Powder. Like with this powder, I'm going to set my whole face. Okay, so let's boss up this face because it needs it like really bad. So normally I would use my NYX bronzer, like you all know, but I'm also going to use it. Don't worry. But I'm also going to use, like, for a little contour, my W7 Life is a Peach Matte. Oh my god, there goes my brush. Matte bronzing powder in the color Beach Bum. And this powder is like a tiny bit darker than my NYX one. So this one is really good for me in the summer. But it is still dark. Like, I was like, my god, it's so pigmented and I love this bronzer. But I'm going to use it now for a little bit of contour today. Because the NYX bronzer is just a tiny bit warmer than the W71. So like this is the base for the bronzing parts, you can say that. A little on the nose. I do not like really like a nose contour. Maybe because I'm like really bad at it. Okay, so now taking a bigger brush and going in with my NYX bronzer. Now like really warming up my face. I got also like a Miss Lin bronzer. It's like really warm. And I'm going to use this as a shade in my crease. Just nothing special. Blending this into the crease and like blowing it out. With this blowing out effect. So for my highlighter, I wanted to do it like a little bit neutral. Nothing too crazy, yeah, neutral. You can go crazy with your highlighter, but like for a photo shoot, you don't want it too much. Like, except for if they ask it, but I really wanted to have like a natural glow. So I'm going to use my Revolution Strobe Highlighter in the color Gold Addict. This highlighter is so beautiful. I once saw like a review about this highlighter that they were not liking it, and it was on sale, so I was like, wait, you know what, let me try it. It was like 1 euro or something, or 3 euros, I don't know even. And I am absolutely loving it, because I can understand why people don't like it. Like, this is not a really biting highlighter, or you can like really build it up, but it's like more for like an everyday. But like, look at this. This stunning, like it's really soft and I like it. So I'm also going to use this shade like really messy on my eyelids, just like this, nothing really special, just give it some pop, blending this in. Before I'm going to do my mascara and everything, just going to bring some moisture back into my skin. So the first spray I'm going to use is the Body Shop Vitamin E. This is going to give you like really some hydration. Like if you have dry skin, this is amazing. If you don't have dry skin, then you don't have to use this. I would actually recommend not doing it, because like you can see, it's really bringing me some life back. To finish it off, I'm also going to use my Milani Make It Do It, just to give it a more glow, like just on the side. And you know I love that glow. And then for the final step, I'm going to use my Urban Decay All Nighter. Dry. So from this point, this is the base. Like, you can do your eyeshadow, you can do your lips crease, you could use eyeliner, you could do like whatever you want. You have your base. Also like with highlighter, you know what I said, you can use, we will use like a pop of highlighter. I just did it for like a photo shoot I did, so I just want to show you how I did like this natural look. So to finish off my eyes, I'm first going to use a primer. This is the Estee Lauder Lash Primer. So I go in with my Lash Paradise from L'Oreal. To give my lashes the last pop, I'm going to use my Essence Lash Paradise. Best mascara in the world. Oh my god, I love this. So for my lips, I did like a semi-glossy lip, so I'm going to show you what I did. So I'm first going to use my Jouer lip cream. And like, just patting this in. Like, it's not like really hard to apply, so it's more, you know, like your your lips like that. Then taking a gloss, it doesn't matter which one you have. Just go take some on my finger. Just so this is the finished look. I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If so, please give it some thumbs up. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. I'm almost at 500. Please help me so I can do a giveaway for you guys. And just sing with me. Hit the subscribe button. Hit the subscribe button. Hit the subscribe button. I will see you in my next video. Bye bye.